Experts at the CDC have warned that mosquitoes carrying deadly diseases are going to contaminate roughly 75% of the United States. Now, according to advice published by the Centers for Disease Control, Americans should wear long sleeve shirts, stop wearing shorts, stay indoors, and treat their clothes with insecticide to avoid being bitten by the deadly insects. The advice comes amid warnings that mosquitoes carrying Zika, dengue, and yellow fever could invade 3/4 of the mainland of the United States. Now, according to the Independent, reports in a paper published in the Journal of Medical Entomology, it revealed maps showing areas where the habitat was suitable for two particular species of mosquitoes, the Aedes aegypti or the Aedes albopictus, to survive. Mosquitoes could start spreading deadly diseases across a huge swath of the U.S. A study found 71% of counties in the 48 contiguous states were suitable for aegypti and 75% could support albopictus. The paper said that the dengue and Zika viruses in particular represents a growing public health threat in parts of the United States where they are established. We anticipate that the Aedes aegypti and the albopictus will be found more commonly in counties classified as suitable, it said. Counties predicted suitable with 90% sensitivity should therefore be a top priority for expanded mosquito surveillance efforts while still keeping in mind that Aedes aegypti and albopictus may be introduced via accidental transport of eggs or immatures and potentially proliferate during the warmest part of the year. Now, Dr. Rebecca Eason, a research biologist with the CDC, said that the maps show that the CDC's best estimate of this insect's potential range. In other words, these maps show areas where CDC predicts Aedes aegypti and albopictus mosquitoes could survive and reproduce if introduced to an area during the months when mosquitoes are locally active, she said. However, the experts stressed the maps did not show where mosquitoes were currently or the place where there was a risk of a virus transmission. Now, temperatures was a very big key factor in all of this. If there was just one day in winter when the temperature exceeded 10 degrees Celsius or 50 degrees Fahrenheit, the chances that the area would be suitable for mosquitoes would increase. Consistently cold temperatures, however, reduced the chances that the insect's eggs would survive the winter, particularly for the aegypti, Dr. Eason said. Rainfall had a significant influence on albopictus as it relies more on water courses filled by rainwater to lay its eggs than aegypti. Now, Dr. Eason said that the maps would help monitor for signs of these mosquitoes. Surveillance efforts can be focused in counties where the aegypti and albopictus could survive and reproduce if introduced to an area during the month when mosquitoes are locally active, or at least survive during summer months if introduced, she went on to say. Now, additionally, the maps can help healthcare providers and the public understand where these types of mosquitoes could be found so that they can take steps to protect against mosquito bites and possible infection. The CDC has produced advice on how to avoid being bitten by mosquitoes and potentially catching one of the diseases they spread. Their suggestions include wearing long sleeve shirts and trousers, staying in places with air conditioning or that use window and door screens, using insect repellents approved by the Environmental Protection Agency, and treating clothes with an insecticide of some sort. What do you think? Is the CDC just trying to fearmonger, or is there something really to be concerned about with these mosquitoes in the United States? Leave your comments below this video. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel and like our videos. Thanks for watching.